In this lesson, I'll be walking you through an example of a well-designed data layer and showing you how I've achieved it. It's not pretty or fancy, and it's not meant to be. We'll save that for the dashboard pages and reports. The purpose of a good data structure is that it's clear to read, well-labeled, consistently formatted, and most important of all, it's in a format that Excel can manipulate, or everything we do from that point on becomes infinitely harder. I've tried to use this worksheet as an example of a well thought out and simple data structure, which demonstrates a number of the key principles which I think are important. So let's get into some of the key things which are good about this and why. Let's start with the position on screen. The spare space has disappeared from the top and the sides, finally. You'll notice the background grid has disappeared, which helps to further enhance the data itself and draw our eyes to the relevant parts. The grid is really useful when you're designing and building, but once you've got it all in a structure and you're using a certain part of space on the screen, it's not important and it can actually be a distraction. Let me show you how to turn that on and off. At the moment, you can see this is all white space. If I click on grid lines in the view menu, you'll see that the grid lines come back as a light gray grid. If I click it again, it will turn them off. It's as simple as that. In the header bar before, we had black text, which pretty much restricted us to using light colours like yellow and other things in the bar at the top as a background. Because we've changed the text here to white, we've been able to use a colour like blue, which is much darker and has more of a contrast between the header and the data itself. I think that looks a lot better. To achieve this, we just need to change the font colour in the cell. We actually want to change all of the cells that make up the header bar, so we just scroll across the top there, click home, and then in the font option, I've just changed it to white. Equally, you can see I could change it back to black and you can't see it very well at all. So let's change it back to white. And that allows us to play with more different options for the background color. The black borders have been removed and replaced by two discrete changes. Firstly, some subtle gray shading has been used on alternating rows to allow your eyes to follow horizontally across without getting mixed up between rows. There's a few different ways you can do this. Two of them are quite manual, so one of them is we just highlight the row and we pick something like yellow, and then we highlight the next row and we pick yellow again. But let me introduce you to the control key. By holding down the control key, you can select multiple cells or ranges of cells in one go. So for example, I could select this cell here, hold the control key, select another cell, another cell, another cell, another cell, and I could set them all to yellow. Using that same technique on a range, I could pick this row here. I could then hold control, pick this row here, and so on. Pick yellow from this box at the top in the fill color section, and it will change all of them at the same time. The quicker and more automated way of achieving this, and arguably the right way, is to use an Excel table. That's something I'm going to come on to shortly. But in the short term, the takeaway from this is that using subtle shading helps delineate between rows without having to use borders, which can distract from the data itself. Another alternative to borders, and definitely my personal preference, is using white space. You'll notice between my columns there's no visible border, and yet it's really clear how the data is separate from one column to the next. That's because we've got just enough white space so it's not a complete waste of space, it's enough to show delineation between those columns. To achieve this look of using the white space, I definitely advise against using the Autofit option. So let me show you what that looks like. So if I highlight the five columns, and then double click on one of them, it's going to fit the column widths to match the largest piece of data in each of those individual columns. If I click away, you can see that actually that's worked quite nicely for things like release year, because the heading is the biggest thing actually in that column. For stuff like genre though, it's bunched it up. And for me, there's just not enough white space to show the difference between genre and gross US dollars. So with all of these things, I just generally advise doing it by eye. There's no real science to it, just stretch them out until they look right to you. More thought has definitely been given to the headings in this tab. Duration, for example, now is the unit of measure, minutes in brackets to represent that the data in the column is stored in minutes. And gross now has USD for US dollars in its title. Whilst that's a huge step forward and removes all previous ambiguity, I would go one stage further to improve the usability, and we're going to do that shortly. The red title that was present in the 2017 tab, let's just have a quick look, 2017 movies, has been removed completely in favour of renaming the tab to something more descriptive. The immediate thought here should be that it's now unclear what year the data in this tab is for, but a further glance shows the introduction of a new column called year, and this is very significant as it means this single worksheet is now capable of holding not just 2018 data, but all of the data from 2017 and 2016 as well, plus any other years we might want to add in the future. Stay with me and you'll see why this point alone is one of the single biggest things I'm going to show you in any of the courses. It's an absolute game changer and it's essential for everything we do from this point on. In the next lesson, we'll be using Excel's multiple copy and paste functions to bring our three different worksheets of data from 2016, 17 and 18 into a single, properly formatted data source.